Hello students of class 7. So already I have started the chapter ratio and proportion, and in the first lecture I have discussed about the basic concept of ratio. So in this lecture I am going to discuss the application part, the word problems of ratio. Okay, so let us start with the exercise question, that is exercise 8.2. So see, in question number 1, so number of cows is given and number of buffaloes is given. So we have to find the ratio of cows to buffaloes. So the ratio of cows to buffaloes is cows is to buffalo, that will be 80/30. So you can see here 10 is a common factor in both 80 and 30. So 10 will be cancelled out. You can directly cancel out here. Okay. So finally we got 8/3, that is 8:3. Okay. Come to the second question. In next question, number of sweet is given 20, and it is given that in that packet the number of chocolate bar is 4 and the remaining are toffees. Okay, so what will be the total number of toffees? That will be 20 minus 4, that is 16. Okay, so ratio of toffees to chocolate will be what? You have to write toffees first, then is to number of chocolate, that is 4. Okay, so 16/4, after cancelling you will get 4:1. So see the next question, question number 3. The measure of two angles is given. Okay, measure of the ratio of the two angles is given, that is 7:8. Okay, so and one more thing is given, that when we add the two angles we will get the supplementary angle. So supplementary angle means 180 degree. So if we add the two angles we will get 180 degree. Okay, so first of all we must know what are the angles. Okay, each angle. So see, if the ratio is given, that is ratio of first angle to ratio of second angle, then we can easily find each angle measure. Okay, so what will be the each angle measure? See, the first angle we can take it as 7x and the other angle we can take it as 8x. See here, I have taken multiple of x in both the cases. This is 7 into x, that means the value which I multiplying here in 7, that value is also I am multiplying in that, in the second angle also. Remember, already I given you many examples of ratio. See, in class 6 also, ratio is in simplest form. Ratio is given in simplest form. So suppose if you are finding, for example, I have given you one example, that ratio of Anna's age to ratio of Priya's age was what? 10:12. Already I told you in the first lecture. Okay, so that means the age of Anna was 10 and the age of Priya was 12. But in simplest form, see, in simplest form we can write it as 5 into 2, it can be written as 5 into 2, and this will be what? 6 into 2. So when 2 can cancel, you will get 5/6. That is in simplest form, or you can say in ratio, we can write it as 5:6. Okay, that is 5/6. So that means see, this is in simplest form. So that doesn't mean that Anna's age is 5 and Priya's age is 6. It means that Anna's age is 5 times of a number, that same number we have to multiply in Priya's, when we are going to find the Priya's age. That is this number we don't know here. Okay, so we have to take that number as x. That means if you take times, okay, x times of 5, so here also we have to take x times of 6. That means we have to multiply by same number to get the to get each angle. So here first angle will be what? First angle should be 7x, and 7 and second angle will be 8x. So according to the condition we can write addition of two angle is 180 degree. So 7x plus 8x is equal to 180 degree. So after solving we are getting x is equal to 12, but this is not in degree. Okay, remember it, this is not in degree. This is just the value which we are going to multiply with 7 and 8 to get the angles. Okay, so here first angle will be 7 into 12, that is 84 degree, and the second angle will be 8 into 12, 96 degree. So you can also check your answer by adding the two angles. Okay, if you add the two angles and you will get 180 degree, that means the answer is correct. Okay, so see the next question. In next question number 5, So do question number 4, okay? So question number 5, the sides of the rectangular piece of the paper are given in the ratio 2:3, okay? So here we are taking the length as 2x and the breadth as 3x, because it is not given that which one is length and which one is breadth. So we can take any of them as length and any of them as breadth. So I have taken the first one as length and second one as breadth, okay? So according to the question, area is given 150 cm². So area, you know, the area of rectangle is length into breadth. So in place of area, we can put length into breadth. So in place of length, we'll put 2x and breadth will be 3x. So 6x² is equal to, see, 2 into 3 will be 6, and x into x, you can apply the laws of exponent. Okay, x into x, the power will be added. So this will be x² is equal to 150. So when we transfer 6 to that side, it will get divided and you will get 25. So x² is equal to 25. So you have to see which number you will put in place of x so that the answer you will get as 25. So the answer is 5, you know, 5² the meaning of 5² is 5 into 5, and 5 into 5 is 25. That means the value of x will be what? 5 here, okay? There is no other value of x, so that the square of that number will be 25. There is only one value, and that is 5, okay? So length will be what? 2 into x, that is 2 into 5, so 10 cm, and breadth will be what? 3 into 5, that is 3 into x, okay? So 15 cm. So students, see the next question, question number 6. Here the sides of the triangle are given in the ratio 2:3:4. So let the sides of the triangle be 2x, 3x and 4x. Already I told you how to, if you are multiplying with a number in the given ratio, then you have to multiply with the same number in denominator also. Okay, so here we are multiplying with x to get each of the sides. So the three sides are 2x, 3x and 4x. In question it is given that perimeter is 63 cm. And you know, perimeter is equal to sum of all three sides. So sum of all three sides, that means 2x plus 3x plus 4x is equal to 63. So we can easily solve this, okay? And we can find the value of x from this. So after finding the value of x, we have to put again in each of the sides to get the length of each side. Okay, so student, please try to do from this. You can easily do it. See, this is an equation already you have done in the last class also, okay, in the last chapter. So come to the next question, question number 7. This question is something different. See, it is given that Amar divided his collection of stem in the ratio 6:5 between his two sisters, okay, Amina and Sheila. So he distributed in the ratio of 6:5, okay. So we can write that let Sheila got 6x stems and Amina got how many? Yes, 5x stem. Because ratio is given, then we can easily write the number of stems each sister got. Okay, so Sheila got 6x stems and Amina got 5x stems. So see, another important information is given that Sheila received 23 more stems than Amina. So according to this condition, we can write Sheila received is equal to Amina received the stem plus 23. That means 23 more than Amina. So if we add 23 stems to Amina's stem, then we will get what? Sheila's stem. Okay. How much Sheila got? If we add 23 to Amina's stem, then we will get the number of stems received by Sheila. Okay. So just I have written like this. You can write in a simple sentence like Sheila received stems is equal to Amina received plus 23 stems. Okay. So please try to write this. I am just guiding you. You can easily write the answer very beautifully. Okay. So just do this one. Okay. Write the sentences very carefully. So I am just guiding you how to do the questions. Okay. So rest of the thing you can do better than me. Okay. So please try to do these steps. And finally, the calculation part, you can easily know, you know that how to solve the further steps, that because this is a simple linear equation and we know how to solve a simple linear equation. So just solve it, you will find the value of x is 23. Now what is what we have to find? We have to find the total stem collection Amar had. Okay, So total stem collection will be what? Total stems received by Sheila plus total stems received by Amina. So this is 6x and 5x. That means we have to add it to get the total stem collection Amar had. So total stem collection will be what? 6x plus 5x, that means 11x. And already we got the value of x is 23. So just put it, you will get the answer, that is 253 stems. Okay. So this much stem had with Amar earlier before distribution. Okay. So students, see the next question, question number 8. Here the numerator and denominator of a fraction are in the ratio of 3:2. It is already given. So what we can write from this first statement? See the first sentence. Okay. So from the first sentence we can write, let the fraction be 3x by 2x. I already told you that if we are multiplying a number in numerator, then we have to multiply the same number in the denominator. Okay, then only the fraction become balanced. Okay, so here also what we are taking, that the fraction be 3x by 2x. Okay, this is very simple, you know about equivalent fraction. So this is a type of equivalent fraction only. So next, what is given? It is given that if we add 3 to the numerator and if we subtract 2 from the denominator. So we have to add 3 in the numerator. So we have done like this. Okay. Next we are subtracting 2 in the 2 from the denominator. Then the fraction will become a new fraction. The new fraction will be what? 9 by 4. It is already given in the question. Okay. In the second line. So it is given that the new fraction is 9 by 4. So now what we have to find? We have to find the original fraction. That means if we find the value of x, then after putting the value of x in this fraction, we can easily find the fraction, original fraction. Okay. So from this condition, now we have to simplify it and we have to find the value of x. So you can do this. What I have done, see, here we have to do cross multiplication. So 4 will be multiplied with 3x plus 3 and 2x minus 2 will be multiplied with 9. You know cross product. If the fractions are equivalent fraction, then we can do the cross product and we can equate the two values. So here this is multiplied with this and this is multiplied with this. So left hand side part and right hand side part are equal. So you can now collect the like terms and you can easily solve. So after finding the value of x from this condition, just put in this one, okay, in this fraction. So you will get the fraction. That means you have to, suppose the value of x comes like 6 or 7, it may be, suppose 7. So you have to put 7 here. So 3 7s are 21 and 2 7s are 14. So 21 by 14 is our original fraction, okay. So students, please try to do the remaining question. If you have any difficulty, any doubt, don't collect, okay, just ask me regularly, okay. Don't collect your doubts. I'm telling you many times, don't collect your doubts, just ask me, okay. After doing the question, if you came to know that you are having doubt in this question, just send me the message, okay. I will clear it by calling or by doing the calculation, and I will send you again, okay. So students, thank you.